Test. Okay, it works. Thank you. Okay, my name is Sveta Smirnova. Good evening. My name is Sveta Smirnova, and I work in MySQL support group in Oracle. And like any other good engineer, I'm lazy. And this is why I like tools which make my job easier, so I can be even more lazy. And one of these tools is Performance Schema, which is a great tool in which we will discuss now today. But looking at this slide, you may think that's watch. Is it a simple, easy tool? It's 52 tables in 5.6, 554 instruments and 31 variables just to tune it. Is it in 5.7? It's even more. But Performance Schema created, it's like it's schema very structured, and the table names, it's like they are grouped in by things which they help to troubleshoot. And once you understand what you can do with Performance Schema, you can easily just query, just like show tables, like query information schema about it, and you find out what it does and how to write effectively effective queries for Performance Schema. Okay, so what can we troubleshoot? Performance Schema first introduced in version 5.5, and in that it's that version, you could only troubleshoot servers bottlenecks like caused by logs, mutexes, I/O. So it's actually Performance Schema works like probably some of you know is how detrace. So it has instrumentation in the code, and when code executes, it's this counter increases. In the very first version, it was only this instrumentation. It required quite knowledge of MySQL Server internals. But in version 5.6, Performance Schema developers turned face to DBAs who don't know MySQL Server code by heart, and created instrumentation for troubleshooting statements, stages, it's like what you see in show process list, it's query stages, and connection issues. Then in 5.7, added new amazing features. It's, I don't have it on this slide, it's metadata log instrumentation, it's memory usage instrumentation, and has replication replication related tables and more, and it's growing now, it's in development. Okay, so before using Performance Schema, you need to set up it. That means you need to enable those instruments which you want to use and disable what you don't want to use. So you can do it by either writing query about Performance Schema, or by installing that's called C-Schema, which just set of views and stored routines which help to use Performance Schema. It was written originally by Mark Lead, but now it's project growth, and I know support engineers work on it, and it's open for contribution. This schema, it's like it's enables consumers for troubleshooting weights, and this enables everything for all instruments. Okay, so let's start with real troubleshooting case. So it's what happens in site server. So you can see it's available site version 5.5. But in the latest version contains more instruments, you can know more, like in the DB instrumentation, for example. So you have, it's at least first it's I/O, it's files, it's what happens in sockets, tables. Then it's mutexes, logs, conditions, so how much you can just run like sysbench test and monitor what which exact code executed and where is the bottleneck. Okay, so let's show example. For example, but I'm not sure if it will work in 5.5. It's probably instrumentation exists only in later version. But so what I did is I just created a big sysbench table and altered it. Then I run some load in parallel client just to see more weights, and run this performance schema query to see what is going on. And now we see it's, unfortunately, I just cannot make all output here because it's otherwise font will be so teeny, so nobody will see it, even me. But what we should do with see it's counts maximum time, average timer weight, it's on the first loads, which something happens with InnoDB temporary file. And here it's count star, it's maximum read write log about index 3. So let's do it in we are doing it like you see, we're adding key here. So at least we know what something happens. But what happens to help what happens, it cost it will help see schema view IO global by file by bytes. I'm sorry, I have to read it. And here it clearly shows what is data dir in ADB merge file, it's 156 gigabyte. And here we see size of our table is 480 megabytes. So now it's, I think many of you know what alter was slow, but now it's proved why it's slow. You know why it's slow. Okay, so what else another amazing features, it's statement troubleshooting. So this performance schema contains like table name, it has table name like current, about what has happened right now, history, story. What's happened, it's last, I think, 10,000 events, or I think last 1,000 events, and history long. It's about last, it's this SE table, size of history tables SE table. Okay, so this information about statements contains is event statements tables, group of tables. It's information about statements, so queries which you run, comments like comquiet, comping, which is like MySQL admin sends to server, errors, they are specific. And 5.7 has instrumentation for storage routines, so which we, I think many of us always wanted. So what is how to use it? It's which, for example, we can ask like which queries do not use indexes. We need this very condition: no index used or no good index used. And we see that we found some query which doesn't use index. We can do so even with a nicer view from this schema. Again, I need to read statements with full table scans. So we see total latency, no index used, examined 400,000 rows to just to send one. So certainly shows what problems which you can have. Okay, so what else worth attention? Of course, it's it's in columns in the statement tables. It's about temporary tables, about everything which shows that query is not optimized, like creating temporary tables, select scan, sort scan, etc. And what is good about performance schema? Before we could not have this information per statement. We had handler status variables. We could have explain which, but we cannot find out just like we have some statements. We just run in parallel query performance schema, we know which statements are not effective. So that's earlier that we like we saw support asked for handler variables. We saw like created temporary tables increased asked for. Slow query log, do it, but now we can just query performance schema and find out what is going on. And also this is views in a sys schema which related to statements table. Next, which is again available in 5.6, it's performance schema stages table. We contain stages which happen during query execution. It's like you could see in show process list on information schema process list. And probably you know it's a community extension show profile. This is a replacement, but more powerful replacement of show profile. But you need to understand limitation here is that stages which are shown in show process list, and they are server level, so no engine information here, no engine specific information here. Okay, so example, which states took critically long time, so which like because queries, if you won't have very condition here, we will see the many states. So most critical time it's sending data. It can be nothing rough if you doing like select star from a table with millions of rows, but now we are selecting a single row, so it shows creating a temporary table. Okay, so what else is worth attention? It's first, of course, it's related to temporary table. Everything related to logs. Waiting for, these are logs too, but I want you to pay attention for these states. It's taken from my support engineer experience. And why these states is like end, freeing items, and why they, about sending data, I just told you why it's important. Regarding these states, it's they because are vague and they actually contain many. No, it's actually we should be split to more stages. That's we have support request, but feature request, but it's not implemented. Like for example, like freeing items, it's some places it frees query cache, and sometimes I think end shows some query cache problems. And you don't know what happens, and if your statements stuck in these stages, that can be a problem. Okay, so now it's I miss a few features from 5.6, but because I want to show you very nice features, 5.7, it's memory summary tables. When I wrote my book MySQL Troubleshooting, which Vlad just advertised, I wrote about memory and asked it if you see memory issues, collect information from operating system. You can have some information about memory in status variable, and, but this is not what's the problem. You cannot see it's like it's not per server part. You don't know how memory is. You can just make guesses like. If you say, for example, status created temporary tables, no disk temporary tables, it goes to temporary tables. InnoDB monitors output some information about InnoDB internals, but it's little, and still no other engine does do it. From operating system, again, you just cannot see what happens inside. But in 5.7, you see very detailed information where your memory goes. No, it's first I just show it like what total memory server executes. It's for use case for it, for example. Sometimes it's like server allocates memory, then freeze, and sometimes operating system doesn't show it like freeze. So you can just check this view. And find out if it's this the case and or really this memory leak in MySQL server. But more interesting things, it's like actually it's part. It's I want to point you to my blog where I wrote about this case long article with details. But what happens here? Here it's it was replication bug report at bugs.mysql.com. It was repeatable bug report and slave leaked memory. So I decided to find out what is leaking memory because suggesting workaround it's different. Like if it's SQL spread leaks memory, you could increase buffers. It's doing things like so like SQL spread executes better. If IO spread it's very different. So you see now it's IO spread. It's I light load run load. Then stop it, then waited it for some time, and I see it still shows IO free still has 1 gigabyte allocated, it isn't going to free it. And SQL slave, it's not the reason of a memory leak. So you can see it's even although it shows server internals, I think it's readable for any DBA. It's you don't need, so you can guess what is going on and you can find out workaround. Oops. Okay, so what else worth attention? Else is tables. They are created, you can have statistic by freed, by host, by account. So like if you, for example, if some connection is the most expensive regarding memory, so you can just kill it, close it. If you use some host, maybe you may find an attack and do something like this. And also there are C-schema views for for this memory table, so you can use it too. Okay, so actually sessions here are short, and I did not include much about all features which did I miss. At first, which I want to point you, it's 5.7 feature. It's metadata lock instrumentation. Everybody knows what metadata lock is. Okay, so metadata lock is lock which set by server. It's transactional locks which set by server. In any case, when you access a table like run select, insert any query. It sets to prevent parallel connection to run DDL, DDL to alter the table. What's the problem with metadata locks? So somehow you see queries, it's like in a show process list, like some query waits for the lock, and maybe waits for metadata lock, but you don't know which query holds the lock. And before 5.7, it was not possible. You could just imagine. And 5.7, we have it's which holds the lock, which waits the lock. So we have. Also, second feature, it's host cache table. What is this host cache? It existed, it assigns very, very, very early versions of MySQL. And it hosts, when MySQL accesses DNS, it hosts data retrieved, so to speed up future connections. But sometimes host hash have like got, I don't know, maybe corrupted, maybe not corrupted, just DNS changed. And people, customers, users start receiving wired errors. So before it's like, no, it's actually now we are doing so because 5.7, not now, it's, I'm sorry, before 5.6, we. When customers sent us about this such issues, we just asked them to apply all known workarounds one by one. So like this doesn't work. Okay, so let's try this one. So now we have instrumentation and we can see it. Next feature, it's host cache exists in 5.6. Next feature is replication tables. I remember one of, I think, Justin about FlexUse presentation told about they are harder to use. In my opinion, they are easier to use because they are tables. Where you can use them like in cron jobs and in events. It's much easier to query a table than parse show status output, especially if you are doing like, I don't know, from event on stored routine, etc. There are many, many new instruments. Instruments, it's what is this? It's what you can instrument. So there are hundreds of new instruments. And you also, that's not feature how to tune performance schema, but what I did to describe, performance schema is helps to show you what happens inside the server, but it's expensive. Every such every counter it takes some downtime because you need to one more call. But to use it, enabling whole instruments, it's not good idea unless you are just for testing purpose. So you need to understand how it works, which instruments are more expensive, which instruments are less expensive. And great sources of information for this is post blog of performance schema author Mark Alf. It's here. It's RUCOM, it's at your country. And he, Altov, it's, I don't see, it's probably lately not updated, but regarding performance schema setup, it's still very actual, and I recommend you to examine this blog. Next link, it's we are at references slides. Next link, it's GitHub of where MySQL sys schema are located. Then it's a blog of Dmitry Kravchuk. Dmitry Kravchuk, it's his performance lead in MySQL. In Oracle, he makes tests and he uses performance schema for his tests. He explains a lot about how to use it, how make it fast, and how to set up. It's worth reading. Next, this is user manual. Then I wrote a few blog posts about using memory tables in my blog. And slides created a year and a half ago. They contain more detailed version of this session. Although they don't contain, I think 5.7 features just because it was created a year and a half ago. Okay, I need to show you this slide again. Thank you. If you have questions, please ask.
Not really a question. I just want to let you know I have another tool. It's on GitHub. It uses a union all statement to capture a snapshot of the performance schema and write it into history tables. So you can look at your performance schema over time, and you can graph your threads and all of that from the history tables.
Okay, so what is the name of the tool?
What's that?
Which is the...
What's the name?
Oh, it's in my... fork of DBA helper.
The fork of DBA helper.
Yeah.
Okay, so it will collect all the information all the time. Actually, I saw this feature, I heard this feature request from when I presented similar topic before.
I'll send you a link. I can send you a link.
Okay, thank you.
I'll have a blog about it too.
Thank you. Thank you. Oh, I'm sorry.